Hi. So today we have Lakshya Sehgal with us. At the age of 24, he started his own company called Spektron Solar. Hi, Lakshya.
Hi, Geetika.
So you want to tell something about your company?
Yeah. So I started my company in 2016. The idea behind Spektron Solar was to help entrepreneurs start a solar installation business in their own locality, mainly in tier 2, tier 3 towns across India. So we do rooftop solar installations and also help engineers, entrepreneurs and also faculties get trained on solar technology.
Wow. So let's get in a conversation with him and see how his journey has been. So Lakshya, what triggered the love for nature in you?
Yep. So it all started because I used to go for early morning walks with my dad to a nearby place called Surajkund where I was brought up. And I saw the lake and the flora and fauna around the place, the lake drying up, the flora and fauna being changing, and that basically triggered me because it was my happy place when I was a kid. I used to go there for doing boating, kayaking and obviously playing all other sports with my dad. So it really affected me as a kid because that was my happy place as always been. And I remember, being really sad about it, almost literally crying that I need to do something about it, how this can happen. And obviously there were newspaper articles and it was a front page news that Aravali is being encroached by miners and poachers and real estate people. And that was the trigger point that I realized that I have an inclination and love for nature, especially plants.
Not many people think that way. Then what was your next step? Like what gave you this idea and how solar power came into this picture?
Yes, so at that time I was a kid, I was a novice and I had no idea of what to do in life and how I can solve this. So I was just agitated and angry that this happened. So I thought I'll become an environmental lawyer or maybe an architect to solve this. I thought of filing cases against all these people, but then I realized that I'm just being resentful in my approach. And one fine day, one of my friend's dad got him a solar cell, which I saw in my science class. And when I saw it really practically working, I got really intrigued in with the technology and I got really into it. So I kept on researching about it and then I figured out that I need to study it as a professional course, and that's why I did my master's in renewable energy. To pursue a career, to provide technology as a solution for all these problems.
So till now, like how many people have you trained and what kind of people do you train and what is your approach towards training them? Is it different for different people or?
Yeah, so basically we got into training because I started off by doing solar installations in Delhi for a corporate. So I was handling sales and marketing and also I was part of the R&D before. And I realized that, the problem is that a lot of people who are going to install, like electricians, entrepreneurs, even engineers are not aware about this technology. And also mainly customers are also not aware why they should go for solar. So it was a twin problem that we wanted to approach and training could solve that. So I became part of a company which was focusing on training faculties and engineers and technicians. And we did a lot of UNDP, MNRE projects and USAID projects where we went to different parts of the country in rural areas and helped technicians, faculties get trained on solar technology. Where I realized that more than the faculties and technicians, there were entrepreneurs who had their internal entrepreneurship spirit. They came forward and wanted to learn for those workshops. So then I realized that, oh, it's a very good opportunity if people who have entrepreneurship spirit are really coming forward to get trained in a workshop, which is generally very technical and theoretical in nature, but still they're ready to spend their 2 days and sit down and understand, even they come from a non-engineering background. That means they really deserve a good training program. So that's why we started to develop a training program specifically focused on entrepreneurs starting helping with starting a local solar business in their area.
youth wanting to do so much for society and learning about implementation and the technical things that the solar power involves, because it's a vast sector. And then youth coming up and taking this up is really inspiring. So like now you have a team of those entrepreneurs.
Yes, so we have partnered with entrepreneurs ranging from Guwahati till Rajasthan. We have one in Uttarakhand, one in Gujarat. So almost all part of major states of North India we've covered. And soon we would want to venture into different parts. We do get requests from people from other parts of the country. But as I'm also really young and I have a very small startup right now. So we're trying to expand our wings to every possible way. That's why we are now converting our offline program also into a partial online mode program, so that we can at least reach out the basic information to maximum people through an online medium.
What are the main challenges that you think that the renewable sector has in our country, and do you think the government is supportive enough when just somebody wants to come up with new ideas about this?
So when we talk about the solar sector, it's subset of the energy sector in general. So the energy sector, everywhere across the world, you take oil, gas, the coal, any power generation or energy sector at large, it's highly government driven. It's very less affected by the technology, though technology plays a factor, but the major factor is government policies around it. So, but solar and wind, which are the renewables, are the only space which can make a house independent of the government interference. You can totally live on solar on your own. You don't have to rely on government supplying you power. And this versatility in the solar technology, that it can power a small calculator and it can power your house and it can power a specific device in your factory if you want to. This brings solar the edge over other energy supplying technologies like coal or wind, as you can say, or nuclear also, because they other technologies have to be at a very large scale and have to be totally government driven, government sponsored or subsidized. But solar does not need that to be.
How you make sure that each family in the country gets that awareness about this concept and implement it, because creating the trust in people is very important. So how are you making sure that happens?
Yeah, absolutely right. So I'll tell you one example. We installed solar in one of the houses in Saket, and the person who was the owner of the house got it done, the whole installation, and after the installation he told me that I talked to you and you convinced me, but still I don't understand how it's going to work for me, so I have to wait for 2-3 months to understand how everything is working for me only after the system is installed. So I realized that even if I try and make a customer understand, I am just one person who will be able to reach maybe some X amount of people. But only if I am able to have equal number of spokespersons that I train, that means good amount of trained entrepreneurs in different cities, I won't be able to reach out to every part of India. So that's what our major focus is, that we would want to partner or train other solar entrepreneurs who can then spread the word in their locality through their network, through their connections, through their family and the circle that they have. So we would want to tap into different circles of entrepreneurs across India and tell them the right way to approach a customer, the benefits the solar has, and why they should be in this sector and why our customers should be installing solar plants.
Our society needs more people like you, and world cares about the money, but what we need right now is some step and some steps and inclination towards environment. So you can support him. If you want to join his team, you can. He is a very approachable person. His contact details, his email ID is in the description. Feel free to approach him and contact him for the details on Spektron Solar and to join his team.